Hey everyone, so today I'm going to be telling you about significant figures, so what they are, how do you count them, how you should show your result or represent your result depending on the number of significant figures you should show, and finally how you should round a number to a certain number of significant figures as asked. Also, I'm going to give you a website that I found that may be really useful while you're still not very familiar or comfortable with significant figures, and it will help you with identify the number of significant figures and also telling you how you should represent your result or how you should round them. So here we go. Significant figures are, by definition, digits that carry meaning contributing to its value. So they are numbers, they are going to mean something for the value that you're looking or checking or the value that is represented. I know it doesn't make a lot of sense right now, but that's why I have the rest of the video explaining you a little bit more of significant figures. So if you want to know the number of significant figures in a measurement, there are five rules. I mean, I put it as five rules. There are five rules that can help you to do so. So rule number one, all non-zero values are significant. So they are counted as significant figures. Number two, all zeros between non-zero digits are significant. So if you have a zero, it will be a significant figure if it is between non-zero digits, okay? Number three, for numbers smaller than one, zeros after the decimal place are non-significant. And you're going to see some examples of this as well, okay? Rule number four, a zero to the right of a decimal and after a non-zero is significant, so is a significant figure, even though is a zero, okay? And all other zeros, they are non-specified here, so I didn't give a rule for that. If you see a zero, it's going to be non-significant, okay? So, again, all non-zero values are significant. All zeros in between non-zero digits are significant. For numbers smaller than one, zeros after the decimal place are non-significant, and a zero to the right of a decimal and after a non-zero is known as being significant. All other zeros, any other things that I didn't specify in the rule, in these rules, if you see zero, is going to be non-significant. So, examples of these rules, let's go. Rule number one, all non-zero values are significant. So here I have 65 that has two significant figures, just like 6,500 has two significant figures. The reason for that is because I have two non-zero values, but the other ones are zero. So 6 and 5 are significant figures, 0,0 is not, okay? Rule number two, all zeros between non-zero digits are significant. So 102 has three significant figures because one is significant, two is significant, and zero is going to be significant because it's in between non-zero values. Rule number three, for numbers smaller than one, zeros after the decimal place are non-significant. So here I have 0.0000000 and 1, 2, 3. This number has three significant figures. It does not matter how many zeros I'm going to put after the decimal place. They do not count, okay? Because the number is smaller than one, okay? So it has three significant figures. So number smaller than one after the decimal place, the zeros do not count, so is 1, 2, 3. Attention, because I don't want you to get confused with the next one. So the next one says a zero to the right of a decimal place and after a non-zero is significant. So if I would have a number somewhere in here, then that zero, those zeros are would become significant, not would go. Anyway, so 0.640 has three significant figures, 6, 4, and 0, because is a zero to the right of a decimal place and after a non-zero value. So this zero here is significant, just as 64.0 has three significant figures because 6, 4, and 0 are going to be seen as significant figures. Again, look at this zero, it's to the right of a decimal and after a non-zero, so it's going to be significant, okay? So don't confuse rules 3 and 4, okay? And finally, all other zeros are non-significant. So for example, 250 has two significant figures. This is just like the number one rule, okay? So here are the rules that are going to help you. If you know them well, you're going to do that just fine, okay? And as always, I have some exercises just for you to try. So pause the video if you want to try them, and what, you know, and you should anyway. And if you don't pause the video now, I'm going to carry on and you're going to see the answers, okay? So, number 72,000, it has two significant figures. What is the rule that I'm applying here? Is the rule that all non-zero values are significant, okay? Number 0.0506, it has three significant figures, okay? What is the rule that I'm applying here? Well, I'm applying the rule that all zeros between non-zero digits are significant, so 5, this 0 and 6 are significant, and also that for numbers smaller than 1, zeros after the decimal place are non-significant. So this one is not a significant figure, but this one is, okay? So the first two zeros are not significant, the third 0 is, okay? Then 19.045, so it has 5 significant figures. Reason why? Because all zeros between non-zero digits are going to be significant. So I have 9, which is a non-zero, I have 45, which are non-zero, and then I have 2 zeros in between. These are going to be significant figures. So it has 5 significant figures. All the numbers are significant figures here, okay? Same way, 10,004, it has 5 significant figures. It's exactly the same rule, even though that I do not have a decimal place. All zeros between non-zero digits are significant. 78.0 is going to have 3 significant figures. This is because, this is the thing between rule 3 and 4. This is because a 0 to the right of a decimal place and after a non-zero is significant. So this guy, this 0 here is going to be significant because although it's after a decimal place, the number before it is going to be an 8, which is a non-zero value. Then I have 0.3200. This number has 4 significant figures. The reason for that is because I have a 0 to the right of a decimal and after a non-zero, so it's going to be a significant figure. So again, decimal places, okay? And here I have these two zeros. They are after the decimal place, but they are also after a decimal that is a non-zero, okay? So I have 4 significant figures. And then this number that has a lot of zeros, so 1 and then I don't know how many zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, something like that. So this number is going to have 1 significant figure because although I have all these numbers in here, I have all non-zero values that are significant and the zeros are going to be non-significant, okay, or not a significant figure. And then finally, 0.00000009 is going to have as well just 1 significant figure because, again, all non-zero values are significant. The other ones, I do have a 0 to the right of the decimal, but I do not have a non-zero before that, so it's not going to be a significant figure. Okay, so I hope that now you understand a little bit more the rules for significant figures. Keep trying, keep making your values, and keep using that website if you're still not comfortable about it, okay? I'm going to give you the website just at the end, okay? So, now, how many significant figures should be reported in my solutions when I do some calculations in my tests and all these things? The rules are different for addition and subtraction. I cannot say addition and subtraction, and they are different. Those rules are different than multiplication and division. So, let's go for it. So, the first one, let's imagine that I have the numbers 12.793 plus 4.58 plus 3.25794. This gives me a number of 20.63094. Now, how many significant figures should be reported? I should have the significant figures of 4, so 20.73. Now, this is actually because 4.58 is the number that has the lowest number of decimal places. For 58, it only has two decimal places, so my answer should have two decimal places as well. So this one, although I'm asking about significant figures, has to do with decimal places. Multiplication and division, how you're going to do it. So for example, 56.937 divided by 0.46 is going to give me this big number, so 130.2982609. And the number of significant figures that I should show, or the way that the number should be reported, should be 1.3 times 10 to the power of 2, so in scientific notation. Reason for that is because 0.46 has only two significant figures, so I'm going to use the least number of significant figures. Now, I could say 130, but this would be ambiguous because, you know, I'm showing three digits in there. So scientific notation is going to be necessary for me to make sure that I'm having 1.3 times 10 to the power of 2, which is going to be with two significant figures and not going to make people think, oh, could it be, could it not be? You know what I mean? So anyway, so this is how many significant figures should be reported, at least in the cases of physics. I don't know if the rules are different to other ones, but I don't think so. I mean, I'm not quite sure in here, but I believe so. I believe that what I'm saying is quite universal here, okay? Now, finally, imagine that they ask you to round to certain numbers of significant figures. First of all, how do you do roundings? You have a number, right? And you round it down if the next digit is less than 5, and you round it up when the next digit is greater or equal than 5, okay? So that's the main rule for rounding. So now, imagine that you have a result, just like this, and they ask, oh, but round it to 2 significant figures, or 3 significant figures, or something like. So how do you do these roundings? So let's go and look at some examples. I have here the number 0.004098, and I want to round it to 1 significant figure. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to see where is the difference, or where I would have the significant figure, which would be here, 0.004. The number after is a 0, so it's a number smaller than 5. So my rounding to 1 significant figure stays as it shows, 0.004, okay? Now imagine that they ask me to round it to 2 significant figures. Now 2 significant figures, it would be as 0.0040, this 0 counts, and then after I have 98. Now this 9 is a number that is greater or equal, this in this case just greater than 5. So 2 significant figures I will get as 0.0041. So this number goes up because I had to round it up because 9 is greater than 5. And in this case, I'm showing still 2 significant figures. Does it make sense? Another example. So round 62.789. I was just running out of ideas for numbers, so I was like 789. So round 62.789 to 1 significant figure. So first step, look at where the 1 significant figure stays, is right after the 6, and then the number that I have after is a 2. Now 2 is smaller than 5, so rounding this big number to 1 significant figure is going to give me an answer of 60,000, because again, I have this number to be 0. It doesn't go up because the number after is a 5, is smaller than 5. And then again, I want to see 1 significant figure. So I don't have it as 62.789 because this is going to have 5 significant figures. I need to show only 1 significant figure. So that's going to be the 6 at the top, and I'm rounding it to the closest to that number in terms of 1 significant figure. So that would be 60,000. So instead of saying I have 62,000.789 or 799, I would say, oh, okay, I have about 60,000, okay? And then imagine that I want to round it to 2 significant figures. So again, I first look where the 2 significant figures are. So that's 6, 2, and then I have 789. Now 789 7 is bigger than 5, so if I need to round it, that number needs to go up. But again, so this would be 6 and 3, and then all the others need to be 0 because I want just two significant figures, and these zeros do not count our known significant. So my result is going to be 63,000. So again, I would say, oh, I have about 63,000, okay? So, I hope this makes sense in terms of significant figures, what they are, the rules, checking these rules actually in place. So, you know, having an example at least for each rule. I hope the exercises went well. I hope the rounding went well as well, and how you should do it with adding or multiplication or any of that other stuff. Still, I have something here that is really going to help you, or at least it helped me a lot when I was still not so comfortable about significant figures, which is an amazing website. So this website has a significant figures calculator. So this is the website. They have no clue whatsoever that I found them and that I'm just, you know, giving you a free advert or giving them an advert. Or advertising them to you, you know what I mean. And this is just kind of the print screen of one example. So you put the number of it or expression and they give you the significant figures. You can also do it as a calculator, as I told you. So here I made 45 times 3, 5, 4 times 89, 5.3. I cannot even just say numbers anymore. So anyway, so what they did was they first did the calculation. Then they gave you the result, and then they decided to round it to the right number of significant figures, okay? So here they saw that I would have 1, 2, 3, 4 significant figures, which is the least number. So I'm going to have an answer with 1, 2, 3, 4 significant figures here. Can you see it? And then they added a zero at the end, which is not going to be a significant figure. So that is how it's rounded to 4 significant figures. The number itself was 40605. So because it's 05, this number goes as 1, okay? And then it's going to have this number in here because I just rounded up, so it stays with 4 significant figures, okay? So I hope it made sense. I hope it helped, as it helped me in terms of this website for you to just check facts while you're still not comfortable, or, you know, just a day that you're just a little bit more tired. And I hope it made sense with all the clues and hints and rules of significant figures. So up to my next video. Be happy and healthy. Bye!